Hi, it's V with Crafting Daily Dose. I'm on the Technique Squad blog hop today, and this month's theme is the alcohol ink technique. Now, typically this is done using our alcohol-based markers, the Stampin blends, but I also wanted to show you that it's possible to do this with our classic inks. So using ink from your re-inker or your stamp pad or even your Stampin' Write markers. So this one was done with the blends. This one was done with our classic ink, and this actually combined the two of them together. And I'll show you how to do that. Now, regardless of the type of ink that you choose to use, you are going to need alcohol for this process. This is isopropyl alcohol. It's also commonly called rubbing alcohol, and you want a high concentration, so 90% or above. If the only thing that you have is the kind that's 60 or 70%, you can still do it, but you have to do a little bit of DIY chemistry first. It's a process called salting out, where you add salt to the alcohol to bind up the excess water and get it to be more concentrated. I'll have a link in the description box to a video that shows you how to do that, just in case you need it. And please remember that you're going to need good ventilation when you're working with it. You're going to need something to apply the alcohol, and for that I'm using a paintbrush from my crafting stash, and I've got a little jar to put the alcohol in. I'm also going to be using a Stampin' spritzer so that I can mist the alcohol on. If you've got an eyedropper, that works too. Just gives different effects. Now you need a surface on which to create your art, and for that I'm using the vellum cardstock. I've cut it down to a quarter sheet, so it's 4 1/4 by 5 1/2, which fits the way that I want to use it, but of course you can use any size. The property that makes the vellum useful for this technique is that it's mostly non-porous, but you can think about using other surfaces that are also non-porous. So for example, you can use the shimmer vellum instead of the regular kind, you can use foil sheets, or you can use the clear acetate window sheets like this. Any of those would work. Right now, the gold foil sheets are available. The silver recently retired, but it's coming back in the August mini catalog, so you'll have lots of options. Now, while the ink is on the surface of the vellum, you're going to want to move it around and manipulate it so that you get those pretty bursts of color. You can do this by simply tilting the vellum, or you can use your heat tool to help direct the flow a little bit more and to help it to dry faster. But a popular choice has been to either use a nasal aspirator or an ear syringe, which this is. Both of them have a bulb at the end, and you squeeze it to give pretty gentle puffs of air. This is going to help give you a little bit more control over the process. Plus, a lot of people have this kind of stuff lying around, especially if they are parents. Now, a popular way of getting the alcohol ink look is by using Stampin blends, which are alcohol-based markers, on the vellum. And you've probably already seen this done, but just in case you haven't, I'm just going to show you that very quickly. Here I'm using the darker polished pink color, and I'm just going to scribble in some color onto the vellum. I've got some alcohol here in my jar and my paintbrush, and I'm just going to use my paintbrush and dip it into the alcohol and dab at the edges. You can see how that is starting to move. I've got my ear syringe here, and I'm going to go ahead and just blow on that to help move the color where I want it to go. Putting in some more color here. Now, sometimes people will do a whole sheet at a time. I kind of like working in stages and seeing what I get and then deciding where to go from there. So it's a little bit more of a controlled way to do it. But you'll have your own style of doing so. So this is what it looks like using the blends, and it's really beautiful, but I'm going to show you how to do a similar thing with just the regular inks. Now we're going to need some ink, and we also need a stamping block. The ink colors that I've chosen are Melon Mambo and Flirty Flamingo. The stamping block is basically going to be like our mixing palette. And here I'm using re-inkers because that's the most efficient way for me to get ink onto the stamping block. But if you don't have re-inkers, you can use ink in other ways. So you can take your regular ink pad, or maybe you have a mini size from a paper pumpkin kit, for instance, and just dab some ink onto your stamping block. The water-based ink that's inside your Stampin' Write markers can also work. So for that, you can just scribble off some onto the stamping block. That's Melon Mambo, and then I'm going to add some Flirty Flamingo from my re-inker down here. I've got some fresh alcohol and I've cleaned off my brush, and I'm going to use my brush to get a big drop of alcohol there right next to the ink in both places, so I can get ready to mix them. So I'm just now introducing the alcohol to the ink. And then I'll get some of that onto my vellum paper here. Now I'm going to go into my little jar of alcohol and add some alcohol around the edges, just like we did when we were using the blends markers. And you can see how that already creates a lot of movement. And I'll use my little bulb to blow some air and direct that color where I want it to go. Of course, you don't have a lot of control over it, that you can kind of point it in a particular direction. Okay. And I'm going to continue that process. Now, depending on how much alcohol that I add, I can either make my color more dilute and wispy or more concentrated. So I'm going to add some more Melon Mambo right here. I'm going to now mix the Fruity Flamingo with the alcohol that was there next to it and add in some dabs of that. Now I'll add some more fresh alcohol around all those edges. Get some movement going. If I feel like the color is too concentrated in a certain area, I can add some alcohol to it. And I'll keep working around my page. Adding in some color, adding lots of alcohol around the edges and in the middle. Now remember, the other tool that I can use is the Stampin' Spritzer. So you want to be careful with this to pay attention to where the nozzle is. You don't want to point that towards you. You want to make sure that it's pointing towards the page. And I like to hold it some distance away so that once it gets down here, the mist is going to be a little bit finer. I don't want to be too close to the page. So you can see that not only did that create movement, but all those little fine mists of alcohol that landed there, wherever they landed, you can see these clear areas that developed, and that's a very interesting look as well. know, it's really fun to play with those, and you really could just keep going for as long as you would like. I'm going to do one last sample that combines these two. So I've got the dark Bermuda Bay blends, and I've got the classic Stampin' Ink refill in Pacific Point. So as you can see, you can get some pretty fun effects from combining the two of them together. Now that we have our pretty panels, let's go ahead and finish making them into cards. Now you will notice that they do warp during this process. We're going to straighten them out just a little bit with the heat tool, but what's really going to help is that we're going to mount that onto a piece of cardstock before we try to put it onto our card. But I do find that if you turn it upside down and apply some heat to it, you can then kind of curl it backwards You do want to be careful not to burn your fingers, so don't touch it too soon after you take the heat off. And that does help flatten it some. I've placed the panel onto my Stamparatus, and I'm using the thanks sentiment from the Artistically Inked stamp set. I'll be inking what stays on ink. And I'll go ahead and do that with all three panels. Now my piece of vellum had started out as 4.25 by 5.5. And once I'm sure that this ink has dried, I'm gonna go ahead and do some scoring. On one side, I'm gonna score 1/4 of an inch from the edge. And I'm gonna choose to do it from this side. And you'll see why in just a second. So I'm gonna do 1/4 of an inch. And I'm using my lighter gray blade, which is my scoring blade. I don't wanna cut it. Be careful not to score it too hard because you don't want to tear the vellum. Now on the other side, I'm going to score almost 1/4, but actually it's just going to be 3/16 of an inch, so just a little bit less. I want the distance between these score lines to be just a little bit wider than the cardstock that's going to be underneath, and so I'm giving myself 1/16 of an inch breathing room. I'm going to put it at the 1/4 inch mark, which is right here, and then I'm going to pull it back by just one little tick mark. So that gives me 3/16 of an inch. I've got a piece of basic white cardstock that is 3 3/4 by 5.5. And I'm going to go ahead and put some Stampin' Seal along the edges. I'm going to take my vellum piece, put it upside down, and then center my piece of cardstock over it. And then I'm going to fold along the score lines that I have made so that basically the vellum is going to wrap around the cardstock. And we made the space between those score lines and the vellum just 1/16 of an inch more than the width of the cardstock so that it's going to fit nice and snug but still fit. Okay, so here's our panel. That's what it looks like, and you can see that it fits pretty well and that the warpage on the vellum doesn't matter so much at this point. Now I'm going to put Stampin' Seal over the whole back and I'll mount it onto a card base. There's still some adhesive along the sides here because the vellum doesn't cover all of that up, so I'm just going to add a little bit more. Don't have to cover the whole thing again. Here is my standard A2 card base made out of basic white thick. It is 8.5 by 5.5, scored down the middle at 4 1/4. And now I'm going to take this panel and I'm going to center it over the front. I want to decorate the front with just a simple shape. This is the leaf die from the Artistic die set, and I'm cutting it out of basic white cardstock. Before I cut it, I'm going to put some adhesive sheet on the back. Now notice I'm not trying to cover the whole thing in adhesive. I just want at least part of it to be sticky. So I'm going to peel off the backing here. So this side is sticky. And I'll apply it to the cardstock. So this becomes the back. I'll put my die like this, and then I will run it through my die cutting machine. Now, once my leaf shape has been cut out, I can go ahead and peel the backing off. Here's a piece right here. And then I could adhere that down onto my card. So let's see, put it like this. And I'll just press that down and reinforce it. And then we're good to go. I'll go ahead and finish off the other two panels in the same way. So here are our completed cards. This was the one that used blends only. This one used classic ink, that's water-based. And then this was a combination of the two of them. I hope that you've enjoyed this dose of creativity and that you'll have a chance to try the techniques yourself. I would love to know if you make one. Thanks so much for watching. I hope to see you again next time. Until then, have a great day.